Remember this movie? It was one of my favorites growing up, and although time travel is not available as of yet, I'm going to do my best to give you the advice I would have given myself back in my 20s. Because you might be feeling lost and unsure of where to start, or you may be wondering if you'll ever be able to afford to get into the real estate market. So I'm gonna help you out with the best advice possible for your future success. So fire up your virtual DeLorean and let's go back to early 2000 when I was in my early 20s so I can share my 7 pieces of advice I would have given my younger and less gray self in order to be that much further along in my real estate investing journey. Hey, what's up? Darren Voros here. My mission is to help 1,000 people create $1 million of net worth with real estate investing. Subscribe not to miss what's coming. My real estate investing journey started in 2002 when I bought my first house. But the reason I was able to buy my first property was because of the years leading up to that. In 2000, I spent most of the year working on a cruise ship. And in 2001, I spent the entire year working over in Japan at Universal Studios. Yes, for those of you that don't know, in my past life, I used to be an actor, singer, and dancer, and that profession took me all over the world. I tell you this because many people at that time told me that I should not take these two jobs because they'd take me away from the industry in Toronto and New York, and I would quickly be forgotten. But what these people were not taking into consideration was the financial impact these two jobs had on my life. So what does this have to do with real estate? In life and in real estate, there are going to be people giving you advice that have no business doing so. And oftentimes, it's slanted to reflect their self-interest. Tip number one is to block out the naysayers and follow the people who are doing what you want to do. Take advice from them, follow what they do, but don't listen to someone who has not been successful as a real estate investor. Unsuccessful people are more than willing to give you advice on the things that haven't worked for them, but that doesn't mean you can't be successful. Take the lessons they've learned and use them to your advantage, and block out the negativity because there is a lot of it around real estate investing from the uneducated. My second piece of advice is to get educated. When I started my real estate investing journey in 2002, I went and I bought a house with very little knowledge. That property worked out well for me, but only because the market went up significantly during the time that I owned it. Market appreciation should not be your main focus as a real estate investor, because if it is, you are a real estate speculator and not a real estate investor. There are so many amazing resources available today, and many of them are free, like this YouTube channel. So take advantage of that and get yourself educated as much as possible. Read books, listen to podcasts, join networking groups, reach out to successful investors, and ask for help when you need it. My third piece of advice is to be as fiscally responsible as you can. I see many people in their 20s trying to flex with a new car or renting an apartment that is beyond their means in order to impress other people. Here's a newsflash. No one gives a shit. And trust me, you'll be glad you are fiscally responsible in your 20s when you get to your 30s and 40s. Would you rather make short-term sacrifices for long-term gains? Absolutely. So cut out any unnecessary spending, live within your means, and save as much money as you can. My fourth piece of advice is more specifically related to real estate investing, and that is to get into the real estate market as soon as you possibly can. Feeling like the real estate market is very unaffordable for most people in their 20s? I get it, but guess what? It has always been that way and it always will be that way. I bought my first house in 2002 and the average income for a single male was around $35,000 a year. The house I bought was $130,000. That same house today is worth about $350,000. So it's more than doubled in price, but the average salary has almost doubled to nearly $70,000 a year. So the relationship between salary and real estate has kept pace. So using the excuse that everything is so expensive now is a bit of a cop-out. I know, this video is filled with tough love from your Uncle D. And this piece of advice leads into my next one, which is number 5, buy real estate in an area that you can afford versus where you want to live. This is one of the things that I did right in my 20s. I was living in Toronto at the time, but I ended up buying my first property in Alberta because it was much more affordable, and I purchased a revenue property which had positive cash flow. I used the positive cash flow to offset my living expenses in Toronto. This is a great strategy that allows you to get into the real estate market at a more affordable price and capitalize on the increased market value, but also allows you to live where you want to live. If you want a detailed breakdown of whether you should be buying or renting, take a look at this video right here after you're done watching this video. My sixth piece of advice is if you are dead set on investing where you live and it makes sense sense to do so, use house hacking. House hacking is the idea of reducing your living expenses by either having an additional suite in your home or renting out rooms in your property to offset your costs. The good thing about being in your 20s is you're generally used to living with other people. So take advantage of that before you get crusty like me and want to live on your own. Forever. And my seventh and final piece of advice is to shore up your cash first. Many novice investors search out properties in areas where they can see significant appreciation in the real estate market, but those areas and property types often have very little cash flow. My advice to you is to search out areas and properties that can put cash in your pocket so you can supplement your income or ideally replace it as quickly as you can. If your cash flow is secured and consistent, it gives you the freedom to live where you want, work at what you want to do, and ultimately invest in more long-term growth assets that will build wealth over time. My last piece of bonus advice is to be patient. Real estate investing is a long-term game. The sooner you get in and the longer you stay in, the more successful you'll be. If you're looking to up your education for a minimal investment, check out my Level 1 and Level 2 Masterclass. In these trainings, you'll get a full spectrum of what's available to you as a real estate investor and how you can start implementing those strategies right away. Feel free to drop any challenges you're having getting started in real estate in the comments section below, and I'll do my best to give you some advice. You can also follow me on Facebook and Instagram, where I post regularly. Thanks for watching and letting me take you back to the future.